In this video, I want to show you something that is a very common area of confusion, and that is how to insert a different header or footer on different pages. So for example, let's say on the first two pages of my document, I want one header. And then on the remainder of the document, I want a different header. Now this can be difficult at first because Word, what it does by default is when you insert a header, it's going to go ahead and throw that on all the pages of your document. And it can be very challenging to figure out how to get it to stop doing that. How do I get a header on pages 1 and 2 that's different than the header on pages 3 through 10, let's say. So let's go ahead and take a look at that. So I'm going to go ahead and start by inserting a header by going to Insert and then Header here. And then let's go ahead and just type, this is my first header. See, let's go ahead and first increase this so it's easy to see. So I'll increase this to 24 point font there. And then I'll click outside of there to get out of the header. Now here, this is my non-printing character, and this would not print the document. It just shows me where I am. And I can get that, if you haven't seen these before, by clicking on this button here. Notice it turned off, and then it turns on again. I like to have these on because they show me exactly where I am. They show me if I have spaces in the document that I don't want that I can get rid of, and so on. I'm going to go ahead and press Control-Enter 2 times. And what that does is each time I press that, that inserts a page break. So now I should currently have a 3-page document, and notice I do here. And notice how this header here, as I had mentioned, it goes ahead and automatically puts the header on all 3 pages. But remember, I want to start this 3rd page with a different header. So to do that, we've got to do a little bit of work here. Now notice here I have a page break. And this non-printing character shows me that. If I don't have that on, I won't know there's a page break here. It's another reason why I really like to have that on when I work. But so let's go ahead and go down here and say on page 3, let's double click on that header. I'm just going to show you something here. So I type insert my 2nd header. And I might think, okay, good. Well, page 3, I've got what I want, the different header. And I go up, but notice it puts it on page 2 and it puts it on page 1 as well. So that's no good, because I want a different header on page 3 than pages 1 and 2. Well, what I need to do to fix that is I need to go ahead and first I'm going to undo this. Okay, so I'll press this. I could press Control Z, but I'll undo that so I get back to this. Now, here, what I need to do is right here, I'm going to go ahead and select this page break. Once again, if I didn't have that on, I wouldn't know it was there. So I'm going to select that page break. Press Delete, and then here what I need to do is I need to go to Layout, and then go to Breaks. And this is really important here. I'm going to go to Section Breaks. And since I want to go ahead and start a new page, remember the page break was right here, I'm going to select Next Page Section Break. And notice this says, insert a section break and start the new section on the next page. So that's exactly what I want. So before we just had a page break. So the difference here is I have a section break. So I'm right here on page 2, and I'm going to insert my section break. Okay, notice the section break is right here. See where it says section break next page. So that's very informative. And if I don't have this on, the non-printing characters, once again, I don't know it's there. So it's very important to have that on so you can confirm that your section break was placed in the right area. Okay, so we're on page 2 once again. Now here's page 3, and it says this is my first header. Now what I need to do here, as I've clicked on here, notice this button, Link to Previous. And it says, Link to Previous Section to continue using the same header or footer. So you can probably see where I'm going here. I'm going to turn this off. And then I want to go ahead, and here I'm going to type, this is my 2nd header. And then notice here, now, page 1 has my first header. Page 2 has my first header as I wanted, and then page 3 has my 2nd header. And then if I go in here and press Control-Enter to generate some more pages, let's just take a look at it. And then to make this more clear that it's the 2nd header, I'll do one last thing real quickly. So I'll just start on page 3. Here I'm going to right align this. Okay, now let's go to Print Preview. So File, Print. Then notice here we have, this is my first header, this is my first header, and then second header on pages 3 and 4. And I just keep going. Now I'm on page 7 and 8. So that's how you create a different header and footer on different pages of a document.